This is a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, made possible by the Friends of SDPB. Pledge your support for quality programming. Call Friends at 800-333-0789 or donate online at sdpb.org. You may purchase this video and many others online at our website. Click on Shop SDPB. And thank you.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
From the Civic Arena in Watertown, South Dakota, welcome to the final night of the 2011 South Dakota High School Girls Class A Basketball Tournament on SDPB.org and SDPB-TV2. Major funding for the broadcast of high school championship activities is provided by Dakota Bank.
In Dakota Territory, we honor the past and prepare for the future. Dakota Bank, it's good to be in Dakota Territory.
By Mid-Continent Communications.
Mid-Continent Communications Northern Plains Network is how more businesses stay connected throughout the region.
And by your membership of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Two games in the books in the Saturday session. The seventh-place winner, Tri-Valley, the Mustangs by winner, 65-34 this afternoon. And it was Madison taking a late lead, relinquishing that lead, and losing to Mobridge Pollock in the championship of the consolation round. Fifth place going to the Tigers, 55-50 on the strength of a 29-point fourth period. They scored more points in the fourth period than they did the previous three periods of today's game with Madison. This evening's session, no less exciting, no less fantastic. Hopefully a couple of games that live up to their billing for third place and first place. We've got the third place game coming up first, Clark Willow Lake in action against the St. Thomas More Cavaliers, a team going down to defeat for the first time this season last night, but John Siever, a team proving to the rest of the state they're for real.
Well, and there were some questions about whether they were just a product of their scheduling, why, you know, if it was what was going on with St. Thomas More, Gary. And I think they answered those questions. I had a nice chat with Coach Candleline before the game here this evening and just told him that, hey, we appreciate the way you guys play basketball. We love the fact that your kids compete, that they're solid fundamentally, that they know how to play the game, they play the game the right way. And except for a break or two in the game last night, it could be St. Thomas More in the championship game.
There are a lot of ways that Clark Willow Lake can beat you. Team speed is one thing. They run, they run, they run. They try to run the legs out from under their opponents. And then you look at individual performances. You have Delores who can shoot outside. You've got to keep an eye on her for 32 straight minutes. You've got China Stevens. You've got so many people like, Ashley Grunewald, who can do a lot of things, running the floor, running the offense, just some great things that they can do. They can give an opposing coach headaches for a good long time in a game.
Well, the fact about Delores is if you take your eye off of her, you can guard her for 30 minutes. You can guard her for 28 minutes. But there's going to be that once or twice where the defense is a little late getting there, and Delores is going to make you pay. We saw that last night. Four threes in the first half. Delores on a pace right now, Gary. She's shooting over 50% from behind the three-point line in this tournament. 11 of 19, and three short of the state tournament record, overall record, through three games for three-pointers. She might get that in the first quarter tonight if St. Thomas More can't find her on the court.
All right. This worked last night. We'll try it again. Two words. Caitlin Duffy.
Caitlin Duffy is the real deal. If you're anywhere around where St. Thomas More is playing next year, go watch this kid play basketball. She is absolutely fantastic. She knows when to shoot it. She can shoot it. And at the same time, she's not a selfish basketball player. She sets up her teammates and hands off the basketball, dishes out the assist as well. Outstanding player, very fundamentally sound. I would pay to watch her play.
I have a question to ask, and I won't do that just now since we have to get involved with some opening ceremonies here. You are watching the 2011, but remind me I need to ask. You're watching the 2011 Girls Class A Basketball Tournament from Watertown, a copyright production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting through rights granted by the South Dakota High School Activities Association. We will go to our public address announcer, start the opening ceremonies, and bring a basketball in just a few minutes on SDPB-TV2 and SDPB.org.
Good evening, ladies. ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Watertown Civic Arena and the final session of the State A Girls Basketball Tournament. Tonight, we will crown the 36th state champion for the Class A Girls Basketball. The teams that played this afternoon in the first game were the Warriors of Winter High School. Carrying their school colors is Chamber Hassel. And the Mustangs of Tri-Valley High School. Colors carried by Alex Larios. In the consolation championship game were the Lady Bulldogs of Madison High School. Rayanne Larson carrying the school colors. And the Lady Tigers of Mobridge Pollock. Carrying their school colors is Misty Reichman. In this evening's first game, playing for third and fourth place, are the Cyclones of Clark Willow Lake High School. Bailey Bruns carrying the colors. And the Cavaliers of St. Thomas More High School, with Madison Green carrying the colors. And in our championship game, we have the Watchdogs of Beresford High School. Liz Dahl carrying the school colors. And their opponents are the Redmen of Sisseton High School. Lana Nelson carrying the flag. And now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand as members of the Pine Ridge High School JROTC present the flag of our country. Members of the color guard are Skylar Poorbear, the national colors, Samantha Ghost Dog, the South Dakota State colors, and Brittany Steele, the Pine Ridge Tribal colors. Tonight, our national anthem will be sung by the West Central High School Quartet. Daniel Renner, Sean McCluskey, Emily McMahon, and Megan Shoemaker. They're under the direction of Rebecca Biles. We'd remind everyone to please remain standing until the colors have been retired. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. For the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's
red glare,
bombs bursting
in air,
gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you. Each year, the South Dakota High School Activities Association sponsors statewide events in athletics, journalism, music and speech activities. The Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance, and Billion Automotive, believe that these athletic and fine art activities provide lessons for life, including the lessons taught with good sportsmanship. We hope that you enjoy tonight's state tournament games and that you let your good sportsmanship show. And now let's meet the participants in the third place game between the visitors on the scoreboard, the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones and the home team, the St. Thomas More Cavaliers. First, let's meet the cheerleaders from Clark Willow Lake. Andrea Paulson, Jill Stern, Jessica Peterson, Jamie Finstad, and Laura Schmidt. Their cheer coach is Lisa Paulson. Next, the cheerleaders from St. Thomas More. Hannah Williams. Lindsay Blazer. Hannah Stefanik. And Danielle LaFleur. Their cheer coach is Lori Sullivan. And now let's meet tonight's starting lineups. For the Cyclones, a 5'10 senior guard, number 4, Tess Johnson. And for the Cavaliers, a 5'6 senior forward, number 21, Katie Friedel. From Clark Willow Lake, a 5'7 guard, a senior, number 5, Tara DeLores. And from St. Thomas More, a 5'5 guard, a junior, number 23, Maddie Merriam. For the Cyclones, a 5'9 senior, the forward, number 14, Ashley Tonak. And for the Cavaliers, a 5'11 freshman, the forward, number 32, Maura Duffy. From Clark Willow Lake, a 5'11 forward, a sophomore, number 24, China Stevens. And from St. Thomas More, a 5'10 forward, a junior, number 33, Caitlin Duffy. And a Cyclone guard, she's 5'6 and a senior, number 33, Ashley Grunewald. And the Cavaliers post, she's 5'10 and a junior, number 43, Bree Arity. The assistant coaches for Clark Willow Lake are Joel Huber and Laura McGurr. The head coach of the Cyclones is Wayne Stobbs. The assistant coaches for St. Thomas More are Michelle Herman, Bill Friedel, and Janae Morrow. The head coach of the Cavaliers is Brandon Candolin. Our officials for tonight's contest are William Circle Eagle, Scott Deutsch, and Randy Clute.
Well, we are about set to begin our championship night here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Thanks for joining us all across the land, all across the world, wherever you may be. Sit back, grab some popcorn, and get ready for a great night of high school girls basketball, South Dakota style. And here to serve it up, we just call him the Pizza Monster. It's Gary Ellen Bolts.
Appreciate it, John, I think. And hi, everybody. The third place game is underway. St. Thomas More controls the tip. Hope you enjoy the game and the broadcast. on SDPB2 at SDPB.org. St. Thomas Moore controls the tap. Maddie Merriam has the ball. Right side they head to Friedel. Katie pass it off to the left side. Duffy alone. 18-footer glances off the rim. Can't buy the thrill. And the rebound coming to Ashley Tonak for Clark Willow Lake. Cyclones losing a heartbreaker by 13 to Beersford last night. Lady Cavs losing an overtime heartbreaker to Sisseton. Shots on the way. China Stevens turns. Fires. Got it. It's 2-0. It's Clark Willow Lake. St. Thomas Moore basketball. And down the floor, Maura Duffy. She finally gets it across the line. They'll slow it down and set it up. I don't think the Cavaliers want to get into a running game with Clark Willow Lake tonight. One of the fastest teams in Class A basketball in quite some time. On the left side of the circle, that's Merriam. Looking high and dry. Hand it off to Friedel. Kick it off on the right side, Maura Duffy. Back to Merriam. Deep three on the way. It's in.
Well, that's what she can do for you. You start concentrating on Caitlin Duffy, and Merriam will make you pay.
Delores has the ball. Tess Johnson against some pressure over to the Seiko stripe for Clark Willow Lake. Now facing a trap over on the right side. Grunewald along the sideline. Nice pass to the right side for Tonak. Set it up down low. Delores on the drive on Duffy. Shot rejected by Caitlin Duffy. St. Thomas Moore brings it down the floor. Panic at the disco for the Cavaliers. Shot is up. No good from Friedel. Whistle and a foul is going to go on Friedel. Nice job by Grunewald controlling the dribble.
Well, controlling the dribble, Gary, but do you think St. Thomas Moore saw something last night in that game with Beersford that they felt they could exploit on Clark Willow Lake not getting back down the court on defense?
As in Ellison Klostergaard?
35 points, yes.
Right.
And quite a few runouts on the D side, and that right off the bat start the game, St. Thomas Moore on the runout.
3-2 ball game. St. Thomas Moore leads early. Third place game. State A, 6:23 to go. Tonak's one-hander is no good. Goes out of bounds off the body of Bree Arity. And Clark Willow Lake will keep it underneath their own basket.
Well, Clark Willow Lake has had some early chances here on the inside. Just cannot get those short shots to fall.
Cyclones inbound. Grunewald hands it on the high left. Working around the circle. Friedel on her. Tough of the defense. Head to the right side of the wheel. Delores is there. Covered. Won't take the shot. Get it off to Ashley Tonak toward Amen Quarter to the right. Here's Tess Johnson with a right-hand dribble. Stops. Gets it down low. Stevens on the down low. Quick pass to the left side. Delores puts it up. Nothing doing. There's a foul.
Clark Willow Lake's able to get in the paint. That's something that St. Thomas Moore would not let Sisseton do last night. But so far here early going, Clark Willow Lake's found some room to operate on the inside.
Tara Delores, 5'7" senior guard. Three away from tying a record for three-point shots completed in state tournament play. Is that Class A or system-wide, John?
Class A is the record book that I was looking at here.
All right. First free throw is good. It's a 3-3 game. Delores gets another. It's on the way and off the back of the iron. No good. But Tonak gets the rebound. She'll put up the quick shot. Too soft. No good. Rebound will go to nobody as the held ball is called. Alternating possession gives it back to the Cyclones.
Well, we played the last minute on the Clark Willow Lake side of the floor here.
Cyclones basketball. Tonak will inbound. Better hurry. Quick pass to the left side. Johnson's there. Merriam on her. One-hander on the way and good.
Well, Johnson, a little bit of a size advantage once she got Merriam in the paint, and nobody came to help for St. Thomas Moore.
5-3 Cyclones over Cavaliers. Cyclones are going to get the ball back as Friedel travels.
That full-court pressure from Clark Willow Lake. We saw them use that early last night on Beersford.
Here's Delores to run the office, directed traffic on the right side of the circle, head to the left side. Grunewald's there along the line, extended to the left. On her, on the defense, now off the screen was Friedel. On the top of the wheel, Tonak won't take the three-pointer. On the left side, Johnson wants to set up down low for Stevens. Finally lob it down there. Ball pinballed around. Johnson's got it back. She's in the driveway to the right side. Tonak, 15, good.
St. Thomas Moore taking away Stevens and Delores on the offensive end for Clark Willow Lake. And other players going to step up. That time, Tonak did.
Merriam on the drive. Thunderous block by Stevens. Here comes Clark Willow Lake again. Cyclones down the floor. Johnson stopped the dribble. Down low to Stevens. She'll turn and fire. Got it. It's a 9-3 ball game. 3 minutes into this third place game.
Nobody coming to help double team. Once Stevens gets a ball in the low post, she's made them pay twice now.
The best blocks are ones that echo. And that block shot echoed that time from China Stevens. 4:55 to go. Brandon Candelin says no more. He'll take a timeout, talk it over with the Cavaliers. They're down six in the first period. State A third place game from Watertown.
South Dakota Public Broadcasting provides coverage of the State High School Basketball Championships and other athletic and fine arts activities throughout through the generous support of viewers like you throughout the year. take a moment to express your appreciation of the coverage of these and other quality shows that you enjoy on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Log on to sdpb.org and click on support to make your pledge.
Clark Willow Lake is completely controlling the rhythm and the tempo of this basketball game here. And the question I had, I'll go ahead and ask that now quickly. If you're a head coach, your team's lost for the first time in state tournament play, how do you get them to recover when they're not used to losing?
Well, I think it's just a matter of getting back in the same routine. You know, I mean, you know, at some point you're going to lose. Unless, I don't think you can go undefeated for your entire career. You know, you're going to be disappointed at some point. So just a matter of getting them, hey, if there wasn't anything you did, you guys played well. Let's get back out and get after it again tonight.
Caitlin Duffy running the offense for St. Thomas More. Off on the left side of the wheel with it for just a second was Maura Duffy. Now here is Friedel. Friedel to the top right side of the circle. Duffy, Caitlin's shot, 17, no good. Stevens the rebound. They need an answer inside to stop Stevens on the boards.
Well, and for just kind of follow up on the question you asked, Gary, there's going to be some after effects. There's going to be some holdover of that. Just have to let the kids play through it and play it out, and I think that's what this first half is going to be like for St. Thomas More tonight.
22-footer for Stevens goes 20. It's out of bounds. Cavaliers have it back. First substitution of the game, and that's going to be Madison Kirsch, 5'9 freshman. She has had some good minutes, and what a great proving ground for a freshman than to get in a state tournament.
And we have seen St. Thomas More start slow in the first two games here at the state tournament. They've been behind in both of those games.
Well, they had to come back and beat the number 8 seed winner on Thursday afternoon. That's how things got started for the tournament. Maura Duffy on the high post. Rolled her onto the right side. Kirsch is there, line extended. Tonak is on her defensively. Now to the left side. Caitlin Duffy had trouble hanging on. She does hang on. Starts the dribble. Refigures things on the left side. Friedel around the wheel. On the top for Barry in between the circles. 3:25 to go. Quarter number 1. 9-3 the score. Clark Willow Lake with the lead. Ball on the top of the wheel. Duffy won't take the 17-footer. Rolls around Johnson now. Here's Merriam with the three-pointer. It's good.
And that is a direct result of Duffy with the ball in her hand, driving into the lane. Defense collapsed. Duffy kicks it out. There's Merriam spotting up for the three.
For the Cyclones, it's Johnson rolling around left circle. Grunewald on the drive. High shot is up and no good. A little bit too hard. Rebound is coming to St. Thomas More. Maura Duffy with the honors. First period, 9-6 score. Lead to Clark Willow Lake. On top is Kirsch, works around the horn. Tonak gives her other ideas. They go between the circles now to Maddie Merriam. Merriam, the right-hand dribble, working on Grunewald to the right. Shot is up. The one-hander won't go. Rebound is going to go into the hands of Tess Johnson. Here comes Clark Willow Lake. Johnson with one to beat. She'll stop. Wants to fire over Friedel. Nothing happens. She'll get two shots as the foul is going to go on Friedel.
Well, Friedel was moving when the contact was made. Kind of thought Johnson might spin back to the middle of the floor. Friedel read where she was going, but didn't get there in time to get set before the contact.
Katie Friedel now with two personal fouls. Cavaliers have committed 3 to none for Clark Willow Lake. First is good for Johnson. Tess Johnson, the 5'10 senior. Everybody is a senior in the starting lineup for Clark Willow Lake except for China Stevens. She's a sophomore. Second free throw, good. 11-6, Cyclones lead it. Whipping right through this first period here in the third place game. Clark Willow Lake 11, St. Thomas More 6. Kirk Stopson fires the 15-footer. That won't go. Rebound Delores. She skies for the authority board. After the miss, on the left side of the circle, it's Johnson. Wants the baseline. She'll drive the driveway instead. Stopson puts it up. She can't get it done either as the ball comes pinballed out. And into the contest is Alexis Swedland. For St. Thomas More. Shots up, no good. Grunewald the rebound. One and done. The stock and trade for St. Thomas More most of the night in this early going. Grunewald with the three. It's off the front of the rim. She can't have it. Rebound is coming to Swedland. St. Thomas More brings it back down. They move left to right in half number 1. Shot is on the way. The three-pointer, no good for Swedland. Caitlin Duffy coming up, hustling for the rebound. She'll stop and fire the shot. That won't go. Rebound finally to Delores. Delores the rebound. Pretty tall company around her, but she's able to pick it up. Tara Delores not with a three-pointer just yet for Clark Willow Lake. fact, she just has 1 point on the night. But it is very, very, very early here in Watertown. Down low they come. Tonak on the drive of the baseline. She's fouled. She'll go to the line for two. I think that's going to be Duffy who will pick up the foul for St. Thomas More. And by Duffy, I mean Maura Duffy. And that's who will pick up the personal. Moira gets her first foul. Fourth team foul now for St. Thomas More. And Ashley Tonak will go to the line. First for Tonak. No.
Arity will check back in. Maura Duffy will check out for St. Thomas More. Early going, St. Thomas More, 2 of 11 from the field for 18%. Clark Willow Lake, 4 of 10 for 40%.
Second shot for Tonak is good. They've doubled up the lead on St. Thomas More at 12-6 with a minute 20 to go. Tonak is leaving. And Mackenzie Huber is seeing action for the first time this evening. Huber with some good minutes in the loss last night. Would have been the 69-56 decision in favor of Beersford. Arity has it on the high post. Huber was on her. They kick it off on the left side. Duffy, she'll stop. Decide to fire. It's good. Three-pointer on the way for Caitlin Duffy. It's 12-9. Duffy and the Cavaliers not going away early, John.
No. And Duffy missed her first three shots, but that's what a shooter does. It's what a scorer does. You have a short memory. Just keep cranking them. They're going to start falling. Bad news for Clark Willow Lake is that Duffy's now hitting.
Delores for three. In, out, in.
Two away.
15-9. Delores getting the hot hand from the top of the circle, draining the 21-footer. 35 and counting. First period, 15-9. Clark Willow Lake leading St. Thomas More.
I think if we had a shooting contest between her and Duffy, we might be here for a while deciding the winner.
Cyclones get the ball back as Merriam travels, working the offense from between the circles. 28.7 to go. 2 points off turnovers for the Cyclone, none for the Cavaliers. Marion, the point leader for the Cavaliers, with 6 points. With the ball, Tess Johnson, left side, double team. Go to the left side of the wheel now. Around the circle toward the right is Delores. Here's Johnson, 15, 14 on the drive. Went out without the ball. That's because she was fouled. And you're going to put Tess Johnson at the free throw line now for two.
And Bree Arity will pick up the personal on the drive. Nice drive by Johnson. Saw just a little sliver of daylight. Didn't hesitate. Took it right to the hole and forced the foul on Arity.
And that's one of the things that up-tempo offense can do, especially if you're not used to playing a team that will do that. They get you to commit a lot of fouls because you're just trying to figure out where they're going and what you have to do to match them at some semblance of stride for stride. First is good. 16-9. Johnson gets another. Eyes the prize. Fires. She got it. 17-9, Clark Willow Lake now. China Stevens leaves the game. And seeing action once again is going to be Ashley Grunewald. 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Cavaliers down eight with the basketball. Head to the right side. Here's Duffy there. Wide open. On the dribble drive. Go to the left side. Shots of the way. Arity puts it up at the buzzer. It's 17-11. After one period of play, one period in the books in the Class A third place contest, Clark Willow Lake by six over St. Thomas More, 17-11.
Additional funding for the broadcast of high school championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting is provided by Touchstone Energy, your energy experts, helping you save energy and money on your utility bills. Information is available at StopEnergyLeaks.com. And by Subway, home of the featured $5 footlong of the month, and the new breakfast menu. Subway, eat fresh.
17-11 the score after 8 minutes of play here in the Watertown Civic Arena. 6-point advantage for the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones over St. Thomas More. Really no surprise with what Clark Willow Lake was going to do, and they've done it with some success here in the early going, John.
Fast start, and if you'll look around, you'll see quite a few more Clark Willow Lake fans in the stands tonight, Gary. Now that the roads are a little bit better, that they can travel and make it here. Talking with some of the guys before the game, they were saying, you know, there was quite a few cars that were stuck on the road between Clark and Watertown last night due to the wintry mix of weather.
Right.
So quite a few more fans here tonight. Same thing for Sissonon side of things, having to travel in. Of course, Beersford and St. Thomas More fans, the majority of those were staying in town.
Sissonon and Beersford coming up tonight. The state championship game right here on SDPB2 and around the world on SDPB.org. Second period underway, 17-11 the score. St. Thomas More trailing. They've got the basketball. Caitlin Duffy right side. Working around Tonak. Shot is up, no good. Foul. put Duffy to the line.
Well, Tonak playing up too close on Duffy, and she hadn't taken her dribble yet. And Duffy, too good a player to guard that close if she hasn't taken her dribble. A little head and shoulder fake one direction. Tonak kind of shifted a little bit in her shoes, and Duffy blew right by her on the baseline side.
Duffy's first, good. 17-12. First period stats, Clark Willow Lake 45% from the field, 5 of 11 shooting. St. Thomas More shot 14, made 4 at 29%.
Very deceptive speed for Caitlin Duffy. Doesn't appear to be that fast or that quick when you're watching her play, but try to guard her. Very deceptive.
Grunewald works on Kirsch. Left side of the circle, it goes to DeMores. Now Paulson is into the game for Clark Willow Lake. She gives it to Grunewald. She spins down low. Stevens all alone. Put it up. She got it.
Huber on the scoring end of the nice pass from Grunewald.
Mackenzie Huber.
All right, Mackenzie Huber got that. I had said China Stevens 42 instead of 24. Here's Maddie Merriam with the drive. Her shot is no good. Goes out of bounds. It's off a Cyclone. St. Thomas More keeps it on their end.
No fear in Merriam. Not the biggest player on the floor, but taking it right into the teeth of the defense that time. We saw her and Brianna Buckland last night, a pretty good matchup. Both players scrappy. They hustle. They slide all over the floor. Both of them hit the deck quite a few times last night.
7 minutes, 9 seconds to go. Back up to a six-point advantage for Clark Willow Lake at 19-13. Inbound goes to Duffy on the right side. She gets that for Friedel. Top of the wheel now for Merriam. Over on the right, Friedel. Duffy again. That's Mora. Over to Bree Arity. She works off the high post. Head to the left side of the circle. With it is Merriam. A whistle and a new play called out by Brandon Candelin, the 11-year head coach at St. Thomas More out of Rapid City, South Dakota. Long way away from Watertown. Working for a third-place finish in the state Class A tournament. This is their first appearance in the Class A tournament field. Duffy fighting with Tonak. And the foul is going to go on Tonak as she got hung up with the body and commits the personal.
Tonak going for the steal. Got a lot of the arm
Ashley
in there.
Tonak with her first foul.
It's the first foul for
second
Ashley Tonak.
Foul.
She, the 5'9 senior. Senior dominated lineup, as we had mentioned, for the Cyclones. Friedel will do the inbound. Here comes Maddie Merriam. Setting up the offense on the top. Grunewald on here. Duffy on the drive. Ball is knocked loose. Going to stay in the hands of St. Thomas More and Friedel. Then it goes out of bounds. And I did not see the official signal, but apparently a Clark Willow Lake player was the last to touch it, because Duffy is going to go ahead and inbound. And there's the Duffy inbound to Arity. On the right side, Friedel fakes it inside. Go to the top of the wheel. With it for just a second was Merriam. Here's Caitlin Duffy. Down low, Arity backing down. Shot is on the way. Nothing doing. But a foul is going to be called, and that will go on Huber.
Nice little drop step. Then comes the up and under, and Huber left to grab it nothing but air. And no other option but to foul. Unless she's going to give up the basket to Arity. Well, and so far, Gary, Clark Willow Lake players, other than Tonak, whoever's guarding Caitlin Duffy, the rest of the team, they're doing a good job of knowing where Duffy is on the floor and sagging off their man to help out. Case in point was the last play when Grunewald came off her man and slapped the ball away from Duffy and kind of kept her under control and then before the ball bounced right into Friedel's hands.
Duffy with 5 points, but a very quiet five in the early going. Arity second, good. Well, it's 19-15. That's the closest St. Thomas More has been in a while. John?
This is a learning experience for the St. Thomas More team. This whole state tournament has been because teams have been keying on Duffy. It's forcing the rest of the team to have to step up, and it's going to help them in the long run.
Duffy the other way after the steal. She missed. Mora Duffy got the rebound. There's a foul.
Oh, Mora Duffy doing a nice job on the inside. The Clark Willow Lake defense flowed right with Caitlin Duffy right all the way through to the baseline and left the rebounding position open for Mora.
Stevens got the foul. It's her first personal. Clark Willow Lake has committed 4. Make it 5.
Tonak getting there too late, colliding with Duffy. It'll put Mora Duffy at the free throw line. Willow Lake 6 of 12 from the field for 50%. 4 of 16 for St. Thomas More for 25% here early going.
Just one senior in this roster for Brandon Candle, and that's Katie Friedel playing her last game tonight, the 5'6 senior forward. 19-16 as Mora Duffy hits the first. She'll get another, but she didn't get it to go down, and Huber got the rebound. Huber with the board for Clark Willow Lake. Cyclones making the short half-hour trip from the Clark and Willow Lake area here to Watertown. They have the basketball. They have the lead of three at 19-16. They have never trailed in this game. Looking around for help is Stevens. It'll go to Johnson. Back over to Stevens. She backs down to the defense. Quick pass to the left side. Never got to Tonak as Maura Duffy came up with the steal. Cavaliers can cut it to one or tie it up, depending on the shot. Miriam gets it off to Maura Duffy. Her shot's on the way. Too hard. No good. And partially deflected as well. Trying to Stevens coming up with the ball off the glass. Clark Willow Lake has it down the floor on their left side toward the basket. Grunwald on the right side. Johnson heads down into the circle. Headed with the basketball for the shot was Huber. She missed, went off the back of the iron, wouldn't fall for her, and the rebound is coming to St. Thomas Moore and Duffy. Caitlin Duffy to Berriam on the left side, three-pointer on the way, side of the rim and no good. Ball is going to go into the hands of Tonak, and a whistle and a foul on the push that goes on Tonak.
Well, she started the quarter with no fouls. 3 minutes in, she has three. Or is that going to be just her second one? I thought she was still up on the board. That is her third. Nope, that's third on Tonak. So now what do you do? Tonak has been the player that's been assigned the task of guarding Caitlin Duffy. And looks like Johnson's going to switch over to there now with Tonak going out. Delory's back in the game. She's going to be guarding Arity.
Delory's, Janelle Paulson have checked back in. They out along with Grunwald, Johnson, and China Stevens. St. Thomas Moore's basketball. Again, cut it to one or tie it up. Left side is Miriam. Looks for help on top, finding Friedel. Katie Friedel starts the dribble to the right side. Quick pass to the right. Caitlin Duffy thinks. Fires off the side of the iron. Couldn't buy the thrill. She's going to get it back from her sister, Maura. Shots on the way. It's no good. Third opportunity up. Nothing doing there. Finally, China Stevens comes up with the rebound around three Cavaliers to get the board.
Well, those shots will start falling. If you keep getting close to the basket, keep getting that good a look, it's going to eventually going to start falling for you.
Paulson in trouble along the sideline. Looks for help on top. Delores fires the three. It's back of the iron and no good. Thought it was going to drop. Didn't drop. Went off the back of the rim. Bree Arity coming up with the board for St. Thomas Moore. The Cavaliers falling down the floor. Off the left side. It's Friedel along the line extended. Paulson's got her. Down low. Miriam. Pretty feet inside. It's up and good.
A little backdoor play. At St. Thomas Moore runs better than anybody in the state. Talking to Coach Candleman before the game, and he said, yeah, we got three or four of those that we like to run. That was one of the three or four.
Delores on top for Paulson. She's up high and dry on the left side. Johnson has got the ball, looks inside for Stevens, finds her there in the driveway. Shots up, goes off the body of Duffy, out of bounds. Nope, that is going to St. Thomas Moore as it goes off Stevens.
Well, they hit off the knee, I think, of Maura Duffy, but also then kind of ricocheted off Stevens out of bounds. Got just a piece of her.
But that's enough. If you're the last to touch it, by any method, it goes out of bounds.
It belongs to your opponent.
19-18 the score. St. Thomas Moore's basketball. Pinballed around inside. Ball coming to Johnson. Here they come to the steal. Right back to Miriam. She steals it back. She's going to drive and stop. Turning the ball over. She carried the ball. St. Thomas Moore will give it up for Clark Willow Lake.
Well, she cleared about 10 feet there with a little skip step. And, yeah, yes. Scotty Deutsch with no other option but to call the carry.
Referees and the rules of basketball take kind of a dim view of you when you do that. Grunwald's basketball. Clark Willow Lake has it. Still at the lead of one at 19-18. Off to the top of the circle. Paulson sets it up for Stevens down low. Paulson sets up inside. Can't find her there. Delores for three. It's off the back of the rim. Can't get it done. Rebound. Caitlin Duffy. St. Thomas Moore's Cavaliers bring it back down. Duffy to the left side, thinking about the shot. Kirsch will try it for three. It's up, it's down, it's up, it's in. Two-pointer for Duffy as she's on the line or just inside. She got the bucket in. 20-19, first lead of the game for the Cavaliers. Grunwald going right side. She's fouled. She gets two.
Foul's going to be on Kirsch. I'm not sure if it was before the shot or not. I think it was on the floor.
Okay.
Foul
looked like she was in the act when the call came. Well, she was in the act when the call came, but the foul happened just before the call, of course. That'll be the sixth team foul for the Cavaliers. Both squads with six now. The long inbound going to Grunwald. She wants to drive. She'll put it up from the driveway. Too high off the glass. That's something Grunwald's done a lot of tonight. She put the shot up, but she's forced it and has been kind of wild high. 20-19 the score. Cavaliers basketball. Friedel shot. It's up. It's good. That's a two-pointer for Friedel. It's 22-19. St. Thomas Moore now with the lead of three.
Right foot just inside the line. Good call by the official right on top of it. And now St. Thomas More up by three.
Clark Willow Lakes basketball. 3-point deficit at 22-19. It's Stevens for Dolores. Finch won't let her, or Kirsch won't let her shoot the ball. Wanted to get another three-pointer. She's dangerous from three, but they're doing a good job keeping an eye on her tonight. The pass set up for Janelle Paulson down low, over her head and out of bounds. St. Thomas More gets it back.
It'd be kind of interesting to see if Frank Gustafson got a picture of that ball coming at his head in his camera on that one.
That's a guy with ice water in his veins if he's taking the picture while the ball's coming at breakneck speed toward him, though. Ball on the top of the wheel. Kirsch has it on the right side. Headed off on the top left. Now in the driveway is Duffy. Quick pass off to the right side for Kirsch. Can't get it done. Friedel with the pretty board. Gets it off to Duffy. Her shot's no good. Ball is taken by Grunewald. Here comes Grunewald on the break. Two to beat for St. Thomas More. Shots on the way for Grunewald. That's off the side of the iron. Off balance shot. No good. Alternate possession gives the ball on the held ball to Clark Willow Lake.
And Chyna Stevens once again on the floor.
One of the most aggressive players you're going to see in this tournament, as we can attest to by the
dent in our table.
Yes. Good hard play coming this time around, both by St. Thomas More and Clark Willow Lake. And here's Stevens with the shot. She's not going to get it. There's a foul.
Well, and Stevens did a nice job of drop-stepping to the baseline that time, and already had a forearm in her back and gave her a little bit of shove, a little nudge as she made the turn. That'll be the second on Arity. Stevens at the free throw line.
Chyna Stevens at the line for the second.
Chyna Stevens, the lone underclassman in the lineup for Clark Willow Lake. First is no good. Cavaliers lead at 22-19, took the lead a couple of minutes ago, and it padded it just a little. Long, deep two-point shots.
Stevens on the night, 0-for-2 at the line.
0-for-3 as she misses the third free throw attempt. She's head of the night. Now the ball is loose, tied up by both teams. It'll go to St. Thomas More, this time on the held ball again.
Well, Dolores couldn't come up with it cleanly, and Miriam diving in. Made sure she had her hands on it and forced the jump ball call.
Cavalier basketball, minute 29 to play out the string in half number one. Cavaliers have the lead at 22-19 over Clark Willow Lake. Bounce pass at the top of the circle. That's Kirsch. Miriam has it. Looking on the down low. Quick pass to the right side. With the ball for just a split second was Alexis Swedland, who's back in. Head to the left side. Miriam's got it on top now. Minute 9, minute 8, counting. Period number two, a 22-19 lead for St. Thomas More. Quick pass over to the right side. Miriam looks for somebody down low. Nobody's there. She'll drive and fire. No good. Chyna Stevens alone for the rebound. Clark Willow Lake bringing it back. Can cut it to one or tie it up. They've got 52 seconds to do something in the half. Clark Willow Lake's basketball. Cyclones. Left side of the circle. Johnson's there. Wants help up high. Wants help down low. Finally finds Stevens. Her 18-footer in, out, and good.
Well, that's what Chyna Stevens can give your team, the inside or outside presence. Start paying too much attention to her inside, she'll take you outside and hit the jump shot on you.
28 and change to go in the half. Shots up. Arity put it up and good.
That's a shot we saw Arity take last night and hit with regularity. And that's something that she's going to have to do in order to take some pressure off Duffy.
24-21 score. Traveling violation called on Grunewald. St. Thomas More has it back for the final 15-8 of the half.
I was just kind of smiling because Grunewald, after they called the travel, before she heard the whistle blow, made the toss to Dolores, and Dolores went ahead and took the shot, made the three.
Not going to count, though.
No, she's two away from tying the City record of threes in a tournament.
24-21 here, 8 seconds, 7 seconds, counting. Duffy will try the three.
Nope. No! Foot again inside. How many times today have we seen that?
Most of them. The long shot from Grunewald, no good. At the half, it's 26-21. St. Thomas More has regained the lead. It's their biggest of the night. They lead by 5, 26-21.
Additional funding for the broadcast of high school championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting is provided by Sioux Falls Surgical Hospital. Caring about you and your well-being, you belong at Sioux Falls Surgical Hospital. And by Shields and Shields.com. For the equipment and wardrobe to enjoy springtime outdoor activities, see the experts at Shields.
Tri-Valley has defeated Winner today, 65-34. That was in the seventh place game. Madison losing 55-50 to Mobridge Pollock after Madison led most of the way in that game. And Mobridge Pollock's Tigers able to come up with a 29-point fourth period. Some of the games going on now. Rapid City Central leading Aberdeen Central in the second, 27-23. Highmore Herald, six better than Centerville. That's in the second period as well. And that is for third place in the Class B tournament. Third place games going on now. There's an awards presentation that is going on. And we will let you enjoy that and continue with our halftime festivities here inside the Watertown Civicatorium. Halftime score, 26-21. St. Thomas More is leading Clark Willow Lake in this third place game in the state Class A tournament.
Additional funding for the broadcast of tonight's high school championships on SDPB provided by your Dakota Plains New Holland dealers. Quality and reliability are engineered into every New Holland mower, hay conditioner, and baler. And technical support for today's broadcast is provided by SDN Communications and SDNCommunications.com and by Daktronics, a worldwide leader in video display board technology and software.
Service to the association and the youth of our state. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with deepest gratitude that the South Dakota High School Activity Association's Distinguished Service Award is being presented this evening. Rick Weber of the South Dakota High School Activities Association Board of Control will make the presentation. Tonight's Distinguished Service recipient is Doug Schooley of Watertown. Doug has served as an educator, coach, and athletic director for over 35 years in the Scotland and Watertown school districts. His football teams won the ESD championship on three occasions and the state 11AA championship in 1996 and 2001. Schooley served as president of the South Dakota Football Coaches Association in 2002-2003, and from 2007 to 2010, he served as a board member of the Activities Association Board of Directors. Ladies and gentlemen, Doug Schooley. The other South Dakota High School Activity Association Distinguished Service Award recipients for this year will receive their awards at other South Dakota state athletic and fine art events throughout the year.
Before we make the presentation to the teams that participated in this afternoon's action, I know everyone wants to take team photos. Team photos will be taken in the auxiliary gym, which can be accessed at the northeast corner of the arena. Again, unless you are an official member of the media, team photos will be taken in the auxiliary gym only. This will help facilitate and expedite the presentation of awards. So once again, we ask you to move if you plan to take a team picture to the auxiliary gym, and the teams will be lined up there for you and have their team pictures taken at that time. Good evening. Once again, we'd like to present the awards to the teams that played this afternoon in the consolation games. To present the awards this evening on behalf of the South Dakota High School Activities Association is Board of Director Member Rick Weber. Assisting with the awards and representing the association's corporate partners are Sue Christensen from Sanford Health, Becky Krause from First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, and Lon Reedburn from Farmers Union Insurance. The first team to receive their awards are the Winter Warriors, Abby Norrid, Kirby Bertram. Kelly Norrid. Chelsea Whitley. Carly Tiemann. Tawny Berry. Lauren Anderson. Risha Gardner. Taylor Berry. Jessica Olson. Lonnie Vosika. Dana Dietz. Haley Demers. Chenille Nagel. Cherie Galbraith. Stat keepers, Kristen Hennebold. Brooke Schroeder. Cassidy Hansen. Camber Hassel. Assistant coach, Jamie Kieser. And the head coach of the Warriors, Rana Vollmer. A welcome home celebration will be held for Winter Height at the Winter Armory, 6:30 tomorrow. The winners of the first game this afternoon are the Tri-Valley Mustangs. Hunter Matthew. Taylor Sweer. Kelsey Brown. Nicole Fritz. Chelsea Amundsen. Summer Bossman. Karen Nices. Heather Zeisler. Robin Wingen. Stacy McDonald. Tasha Graves. Allison Cross. Kelly Nices. Team manager, Alex Larios. Assistant coaches, Josh LeBron. Tim Flans. And the head coach of the Mustangs, accepting the consolation trophy, Jeff Breitkreitz. Make that the seventh place trophy. A welcome home for Tri-Valley will be held tomorrow afternoon at the high school at 1 o'clock. The next team to receive their awards are the Madison Lady Bulldogs. Michaela Moore. Michaela McNary. Kara Seitz. Madison Knight. Chloe Nordling. Shannon Spurgeon. Jenna Salgestad. Bailey Millen. Jessica Nices. Holly Fegan. Cassie Potter. Abby Andreessen. Krista Paul. Ashley Curry. Stat keepers, Bailey Johnson. Mesa Boyd, Sam Party, and Mandy Jones. Assistant coaches are Maxine Unterbrunner, and Lindsay Dieterle. And the head coach of Bulldogs is Matt Nelson. A welcome home celebration will be for the Madison Bulldogs at the middle school gym tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock. There will be a caravan starting at Bill and Jean's parking lot in the Industrial Park area, leaving at 2:45. And the winners of the second game this afternoon and the consolation champions, the Lady Tigers of Mobridge Pollock. Michelle McClellan, Stephanie Gamer, Lauren Brecky, Cassidy Ulmer, Maddie Frederick, Monica Bailey, Kylie Kettering, Katie Heil, Kaylee Henderson, Aaron Rabenberg, Keisha Milliken, Ellie Rabenberg, Allie Bond, and Natasha Sandlin. Team manager, Wade Keller. Assistant coach, TJ Knutson. And the head coach of the Lady Tigers, Katie Conold. If we have any welcome home information for the Lady Tigers, you can bring it to the scorers table and we'll make that announcement.
Our Saturday night championship evening festivities continue for the Civic Arena in Watertown. The trophies and the awards for 5th through 8th place have been handed out. Tri-Valley, the 7th place winner over winner today. It was Madison and Mobridge Pollock in the 5th place game. The Mobridge Pollock Lady Tigers winning 55-50. And the decision over Madison for 5th place. 3rd place game going on now. We're at halftime. St. Thomas More has a 5-point lead over Clark Willow Lake. That is 26-21. Additional funding for the broadcast of high school championships at SDPB provided by your Dakota Plains New Holland dealers. Quality and reliability engineered into every New Holland mower, hay conditioner, and baler. Technical support for tonight's broadcast at SDPB provided by SDN Communications at SDNCommunications.com and by Dactronics, a worldwide leader in video display board technology and software. 17-11 the score after one. Clark Willow Lake had the lead there. St. Thomas More a 15-4 run throughout period number two in order to take the lead of 5 points at 26-21. Just a matter of St. Thomas More finding their legs a little bit, maybe slowing down the tempo, changing things to suit their style of play a little better. That paid off for them with a nice second period, John.
Well, it did. Gary and I had a nice talk with Coach Candeline there while we were going through the introductions and the presentation of the medals and trophies for the afternoon and the teams. And he was saying the same thing. He said, you know, if we could just get a decent first quarter in down here, who knows what we might do. And they have. The three games they've played, they started slow in the first quarter. And Coach Candeline said, you know, it just takes a little time to get there. And I asked him about Bree Arity because we saw her last night taking that free throw line jumper, 15, 16-foot. And I asked him, I said, is that something that she does? I mean, because we haven't seen you play except for the last three games. He said, she can. He said she hasn't done a whole lot of that. But, yeah, we like the fact that she's taking the shot. She can make that shot. And I asked him about Maura Duffy because Maura, the times that we've seen her play here, she's really reluctant to shoot the basketball. When she gets the basketball, she looks like she's more comfortable passing to someone else. But she took the shot down here. She had the move. And it kind of caught Clark Willow Lake by surprise.
Right.
And they jumped in and fouled her. And I asked him about that. And he said, yeah, at this point, you know, he said she's got some great moves. She hasn't learned to finish yet. So, you know, the second half is going to be about who can dictate the tempo, who can get back, who can get out to a quick start here at the beginning of this third quarter. And Tara DeLore is still looking for a couple of threes here to tie the record. Three would break it for three-pointers. So, you know, she gets hot. She's capable of running off 4, 5, 6 three-pointers in a row. Just any little crack of daylight. So, and that's what Coach Candeline talked about. You know, we got to make sure we're on the shooters.
First half statistics: Clark Willow Lake 39% from the field at 7 of 18, 20% from three-point territory, 1 out of 5 for their shooting, and then at the free throw line, 6 of 10 for 60%. Rebounding, they had 16 of those in the first half, one more than St. Thomas More. 2 assists, 1 steal, 6 turnovers, 1 block, and 6 team fouls in the half. The leading scorers for Clark Willow Lake in the first half: China Stevens with 6 points, Tess Johnson with 6, Delorius with a free throw and a 3-point shot, ending up with 4 points. Quickly, the first half statistics for St. Thomas More: 9 of 29 from the field, 31%. Even 3 of 6 for 50% at three-point range, 83-3 at the free throw line, 5 out of 6, and no double-figure scorers in the game. Maddie Merriam leads the Cavaliers with 8. We are off. We are running the second half of basketball. St. Thomas More, a 5-point advantage over Clark Willow Lake. It's 26-21. It is Cyclones basketball, original starting 5 out for both squads. Here's Grunewald with a quick pass to the right side, but a foul on the hand check is going to go on Friedel. It should be her third.
Well, and a quick start to the half here for Clark Willow Lake. And officials letting the players know, hey, we're going to call that hand check, especially when you change the direction of the player out on the floor like that.
Grunewald off the screen. This is Stevens on the drive. Travels with the basketball. We come the other way to St. Thomas More.
Defense by St. Thomas More shut down that middle. Stevens, no, nothing else to do except make the traveling call.
26-21. The advantage of 5 at St. Thomas More, looking to go 25-1 on the 2010-2011 basketball season. Caitlin Duffy all by her lonesome. The three-pointer is up and it wouldn't go. Duffy just would not have it fall for her. Clark Willow Lake brings it down. Grunewald heads to the left side. She's along the baseline. Tries to spin out of trouble. Wants to work back toward the baseline. Left to right. It's knocked out of bounds, and Clark Willow Lake will keep it.
But even the misses that Duffy has are close, Gary, to going. Even the misses are close. Don't let that kid discover horseshoes.
And she makes more than she misses on all of those. With the ball, Chana Stevens off the inbound. Come to the top right side of the wheel. Grunewald is there. Looks for help down low. Tonek, keep in mind, with 3 fouls. She is into the game. Original starter and into the game to start the second half. Here's Tonek on the right side. Shot for 3 is off the rim. Glances off the side of the iron. It's no good. Into the hands of Friedel. Katie Friedel gets it off on the outlet. Here's Caitlin Duffy. Quick pass on the left side. Merriam with 8 points, leading the Cavaliers. Duffy has it again. Here's Bree Arity off the high post. Head to the right side now. On the right side of the circle, line extended. Duffy tries the shot. Good. About a 16-footer for Caitlin Duffy off the right side. Puts it up, puts it down. First points of the second half. 28-21 lead for St. Thomas More. Here is Grunewald with the deep three. It's no good. She can't buy the thrill. Coming up with the rebound is Delores. On her tough, on the defense is Friedel. They'll rework the offense. Top left side of the circle. Johnson thinks three. Takes three off the side of the rim. No going to go. Rebound, Caitlin Duffy. St. Thomas More's basketball. 7-point advantage, 28-21. Ball pinballed around. Going to go back into the hands of Friedel. Now sees some room in the driveway. Puts the shot up. It's good.
Well, because of Miriam being on that same side of the floor, the Clark defense couldn't cheat off Miriam and couldn't stop the drive. If they came back to double team to stop the drive, then Miriam would have been open for the three-pointer.
2 minutes gone, six to play, 30-21. St. Thomas More leading Clark Willow Lake in the Class A third-place game at the State Girls Basketball Tournament, Class A version, here in Watertown, South Dakota. Here's Delores on the drive. Get it off to Tonak. Saw some room. It was taken away by Miriam. Bodies akimbo. Caitlin Duffy coming up with it for the Cavaliers. St. Thomas More, right to left, second half. Duffy on the spin. Goes off to the right side. Thinking about his Friedel. She'll stop and fire. Erring in the high post. It's no good. 18-footer went 16. It's out of bounds. Clark Willow Lake gets it.
Maybe just a step outside that range that we talked about, in that right around that free throw line. Maybe a step back from the free throw line is where she's been hitting those shots with some regularity. And then that one just about the head of the key. So just a step outside the range that we've been seeing her shoot from.
5:20, period three, 30-21, St. Thomas More. Grunewald on the right side, around the circle. Whistle foul away from the basketball.
And trying to fight through the pick. We'll see who gets the call. It's going to stay with Clark Willow Lake. They'll have the ball. Foul is going to be on
Duffy. Maddie Miriam, 23, not 33.
Yep.
Irity leaves.
Miriam trying to fight through that screen. Gets called for the shove.
And back into the ballgame, Sweetland and Kirsch, 11-3 respectively. Those are their uniform numbers, not their record. On the top right side of the circle, Tess Johnson. She's out on the high post. Looks for help. Goes to the right side. Tonak is there. Looks low. Stevens covered. Top of the wheel for Grunewald. Thinks about the three-pointer. Going to the right side. Trying to pass around a tough St. Thomas More defense now. Delores will take the 18-footer. Stevens in the crowd. Shouts up. Good. Foul.
Well, Delores, St. Thomas More paying so much attention to Delores that allowed the Stevens to get one-on-one on the inside. And China Stevens is going to win that battle most nights. Nice entry pass from Delores. Stevens turned back to her right and was able to get the shot away.
China Stevens with the first of two. It's good. That's all she's going to get, the three-point play, because that basket did fall.
It's down to six now.
Long way from over. Friedel on the left side. We go on top on the drive. Maura Duffy, she misses. Stevens there for the rebound by her lonesome. Here comes Grunewald. Long lead feed to the right side. Johnson. She'll slow it down. Set it up. Looks for help low. Comes out high for Grunewald. Her three-pointer bombs away. Fire in the hole!
Well, for Ashley Grunewald, that's her first three on the night. Hasn't been able to get free for many shots on the night away from the St. Thomas More defense.
Fired up. Cyclone defense. Watching St. Thomas More try to bring it down the floor. Here comes Friedel. Go to the top of the wheel. Moria Duffy on the left side. Sweetland, Alexis Sweetland, bringing it out on high, reworking the offense on her. And top of the defense was Ashley Tonak. They set to the right side for Duffy. Won't take the shot over Johnson. On the top right side of the wheel, that was Moria Duffy for a minute. Now off on the left, it's Kirsch. Madison Kirsch, the freshman. Inside the circle, Moria Duffy. Caitlin Duffy's got it there. Off the screen, drives the driveway, puts the shot up. She got it. There's a foul.
Don't close the lane down, and that's what's going to happen. And a good job by St. Thomas More of just kind of weaving their way around it until he found Caitlin Duffy. And Caitlin Duffy, with the defense overshifted and out of position, took advantage of it. For Grunewald, that was her first points of the night, Gary. She had been 0-7 until that point. St. Thomas More right now shooting 32%, 11-34 from the field. Clark Willow Lake shooting 34%.
Tonak with the foul. It's her fourth. Janelle Paulson checks in for Clark Willow Lake. Three-point play successful for Duffy. 33-27, back up to a six-point advantage. Clark Willow Lake trying to whittle that down. Top left side of the circle. That was Delores. Johnson won't take the shot. Little tentative from the line, extended left. Here's Stevens. Her three-pointer is on the way. That's out the front of the rim. It's no good. Whistle. Foul. Delores.
Well, Delores out of position, and Friedel, nice job of using her body to shield Delores off from the basketball. I think it's called boxing out.
Of course, the day after Christmas, it's called Boxing Day in England and Canada.
Or boxing up. I got you.
I can never tell. It's almost like you're not going to indulge me or encourage me in things like that. And all the jokes can't be good. You're going to have to expect that once in a while. Lady Cavs basketball. They have the lead at 6 at 33-27. Duffy control trouble on the left side. Kirsch on the drive. Baseline left to right. Spins out of the trouble. Goes right off the face of Miriam. And the ball comes to Clark Willow Lake. Cyclones basketball. Looking right side. Delore spots. Fires. It's good.
Well, on the fast break that time, nobody from St. Thomas More found Delores, and she now has 13 for the tournament, 13 threes.
They've done a pretty decent job on Delores tonight, truth be known. It's just right there. She was all alone. She got the pass. They got the pass to her. She spotted up and fired before anyone else could think to stop her or get back there, and she got the three, 33-30.
Like you said in the pregame, you have to guard her for 32 minutes. You can't guard her for 31 minutes and 30 seconds or for 30 minutes because she's going to make you pay. When you don't guard her, that's when she's going to make you pay.
Cavalier basketball, three-point advantage on the top of the circle. It's Duffley on the high post. She'll stop and drive. She'll fire. Nothing. Off the rim. Nothing as far as points. Stevens is going to get the rebound. Clark Willow Lake brings it down. Cut it to one or tie the game with a three. 2:33 to go in the third. We have zipped right along in this Class A third-place game. With the balls, Grunewald, top left side. Delore stops and fires. She's tied the record.
She's tied it. And again, that time Miriam was up on her, but not up close enough. Delore's very quick shot, Gary. Very, very quick. Doesn't need a lot of space.
Duffy on the other end. Her shot's on the way out the front of the rim. 33-33 the score. Stevens the rebound. Clark Willow Lake can regain the lead with the bucket.
See here's if they look for Delores here.
Grunewald on the drive. Rejected. Halfway into the back student section there. And it goes out of bounds off of St. Thomas More. Very good aggressive play defensively for St. Thomas More. And about the only way you're going to stop the bucket there. Inbounding to Grunewald. Clark Willow Lake's basketball. Six gone, two left. Third period. 33-33, 35-33. Clark Willow Lake takes the lead on the feed and the bucket to and from Stevens.
China Stevens surprising them that time by turning back into the middle of the lane instead of going to the baseline.
Shots on the other way. Arity down low by herself. Put it up, put it down. 35-35. Long way from thinking about this, but I'll make mention since I got the sentence started. St. Thomas More played overtime once already in the tournament. Clark Willow likes, and we're a long way from even thinking about that, but they did have an overtime loss and a tough one. Stevens has the ball pinballed around. Her shot is up. Tripped as she puts the shot up. She's fouled. She'll go to the line and get two.
Foul is going to be on Caitlin Duffy. Duffy, a little roll of the eyes there as they blew the whistle. Stevens had lost her balance and actually fell into Duffy before she could be called for traveling.
Clark Willow Lake sophomore China Stevens looks and fires. She got it. 36-35, Clark Willow Lake leading. Stevens leading the Cyclones with 11 points now. That's actually her 12th point, so she leads with 12. Second shot, China Stevens. What a nice free throw shooting touch there.
Stevens just the sophomore. 21 rebounds for Clark Willow Lake, 18 for St. Thomas More here.
Whistle, double dribble call against Marion. St. Thomas More gives it back to the Cyclones.
Coach Candlin's going to want a timeout here to talk to his troops, try to settle them down just a bit.
37-35, Clark Willow Lake is leading St. Thomas More. We're at a minute 17 left in period three.
If you're enjoying this live broadcast or webcast, join the SDPB Booster Club. When you go online to sdpb.org, click on the Support SDPB Sports on the high school events page, and you'll learn how your donations support SDPB's presentation of all high school activities. Check out the special gifts offers to members and become an SDPB Booster today.
Seems like all Clark Willow needed is to get Tara Delores hot from the three-point territory. That is something that had been lacking in their game. And all of a sudden, it seemed like once Delores hit those two three-point shots, everything was right with the world, and they knew that they were capable of again.
Well, and St. Thomas More, Gary, did an excellent job of holding Delores down throughout the contest at this point. But just forget about her one possession down the floor, and she's going to ding you for the three. And then to compound the error, St. Thomas More forgot about her twice in consecutive possessions down the floor.
37-35 Cyclones. Clark Willow Lake with the basketball. and the two-point advantage with a minute 5 to go. Pass is inside. It's taken away. Madison Kirsch coming up with the steal in front of Grunewald. St. Thomas More's basketball. Tie it or take the lead of 1 point, depending on the two or the three. Here's Miriam on the drive. She is going to stop because the whistle blew and the foul is called on Clark Willow Lake. That'll be on 33 Grunewald.
Foul whistle down Ashley Grunewald. That's her first. Team's third.
Three team fouls, as you might have heard, for Clark Willow Lake in this second half of basketball. St. Thomas More is committed four. 57.2 to go. Cavaliers inbound. Ball goes off the body of Arity. Grunewald is there. She's on the break all by herself. Now has to get around Miriam, put the shot up. Misses. She's fouled.
Two of the quicker players you're going to find in the tournament here. Grunewald in a foot race beat Miriam to the basketball. Miriam was able to catch up with her in the distance.
Miriam gets
short sprint. It went to Grunewald. A distance run. Miriam caught up with her.
All right. That won't happen often against a Clark Willow Lake athlete, will it? Grunewald, left side. Starts the right-hand dribble in the driveway. Puts the shot up, the one-hander. No, she loves those one-handers. And she'll stop just about at basket level and put the shot up from there. They've gone down quite a bit. Sometimes she misses, but we all do. Here's Arity against Stevens. Quick pass on the right side. Knocked out of bounds by Paulson. St. Thomas More regrouping offensively. 30.9 to go. Period number three. 2-point lead for Clark Willow Lake at 37-35. Basketball to the Cavaliers. Miriam starts the offense. And here is number 21, Katie Friedel. Dribbling right hand, looking left, looking right. Trying to spin away from Dolores. She misses on the shot. And Trina Stevens comes up with the board. They've got 10 to get something done. Pan the two-point lead. Grunewald will bring it to the left side. Wade Stobbs saying, hurry, let's get it done. Top of the circle, high post, Stevens, three. It's off the back of the rim. Nothing doing there, and that's how the third period will end. Three in the books from Watertown. Third-place game in the Class A Girls State Tournament. It's Clark Willow Lake 37, St. Thomas More 35.
Additional funding for the broadcast of high school championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting is provided by Farmers Union Insurance, committed to the success of our next generation of leaders. Farmers Union Insurance, ensuring a brighter tomorrow. And by Bismarck State College. In 2 years or less, BSC programs can take you beyond to jobs in the growing energy field. Bismarck State College.
37-35 the score. Clark Willow Lake certainly not going away. They had a deficit of as many as 8 points in this one. It's never been a double-digit lead for St. Thomas More, but little by little by little, you know, they rode the threes. They rode some good inside shooting from Stevens, a couple of fouls along the way, and next thing you know, it's a 37-35 lead with a period to go.
Clark Willow Lake through three quarters of play, shooting 41% from the field, and St. Thomas More on the evening shooting 36%.
Just underway, period number four. St. Thomas More's basketball looking to tie at 37 or take the lead of one if they can get the three-pointer. Duffy covered and tough. Go to the right side. Here's Friedel. Wanted to set up for Miriam. She drives the driveway now, but they head to the right side for Maura Duffy. Original starting five for both squads here to start this fourth period. Ball on the high right. Duffy the left-hand dribble. Working on Johnson. Her shot's on the way. 15-footer. Just wouldn't drop for her. Went off the side of the rim and dropped down into the hands of Dolores. And here comes Grunewald. Left side, Dolores. She'll stop. Fire for the record. In, out. No good. Stevens, the putback. She's fouled.
And that, I believe, is going to be on Caitlin Duffy. That'll be three on Duffy. I think it's going to, they're going to give it to 3-3, and they do. Well, that shot was in, looked like it was going to swish through and then kind of rattled and popped right out. But right there was China Stevens waiting in great position to grab the rebound and power it back up. That foul is the third on Duffy. Sixth team foul on St. Thomas More.
38-35 as Stevens hits the first free throw. Get some of the other scores in the other tournaments. Double A going on in Brookings tonight. The B tournament in Huron. An all ESD state tournament, by the way. Brookings a host, Watertown here, and then Huron as well. 39-35. Stevens hits both. St. Thomas More's basketball, they're on the other end. 7 and 11 to get back into it. Shots on the way for Miriam. Three-pointer good. Maddie Merriam with a three from 23 away, 39-38.
Well, they were just kind of hanging all over Duffy. Wasn't going to give her a chance to take the shot. Merriam stepped out, knocked it down.
Johnson's three. She takes the shot and can't have it. Stevens puts it back up. She's fouled. She'll go to the line.
China Stevens slowly beginning to assert herself on the inside, Gary, using that big physical presence on the inside, grabbing the rebounds, boxing out, and St. Thomas More, nothing to do but foul her when she tries to put it back up. It's either that or give her an easy layup.
And she's an outstanding foul shooter. Certainly has been through the tournament. Looking for her 16th point. No, she got it. She just puts that right through the cylinder when she shoots, and she has done that so many times this evening and this weekend. Beersford and Sisseton coming up in the Class A championship game. Just a little bit after this one's done. Stevens' second free throw. It's good. How many times do you have to work on free throws to do that so consistently, John?
Double-double on the night for China. 17 points to go on the 10 rebounds.
And she leads everybody here. Here's Merriam with a quick pass to the right side. Instant trouble on the tight rope to the right side was Friedel. Here's the shot for three. That's off the front of the rim. That was Swedlin who tried it. She missed. It's out of bounds. And St. Thomas More gives it back to Clark Willow Lake.
And Friedel with four fouls in the game right now. 6:32 to here to play in the ball game. Sisseton Beersford coming up next for the state championship.
Delores to the top of the wheel. Top left side, Janelle Paulson is in. Here is Johnson. Her three-pointer is off the side of the rim and no good. Grunewald hustles for the rebound. Here's Stevens on the right side. Past Paulson on the throw. It's out of bounds. St. Thomas More takes it back.
Well, I'm not sure if that pass was intended for Delores or if it was intended for Nelson. Delores got a hand on it and kind of flipped it up and over the head of Nelson.
6 minutes, 17 seconds to go. Three-point lead for Clark Willow Lake. The Cyclones outscoring St. Thomas More 16-9 in period number three. Now they have the lead at three. 41-38, as mentioned. Duffy right side controls the pass, looking around for help on the baseline. They'll get it off to the left side. Merriam's there, tries the quick three off the back of the rim. It wouldn't go. Rebound into the hands of Johnson. Here's Grunewald, just Merriam to beat. She'll stop, pass to the left side. It's on the way. It's good! Delores with the bucket. It's in. 43-38.
Grunewald did not force things that time. Instead, saw the defense's back kind of peeled off to the right baseline. Defense went with her and opened it up for Delores on the backside.
Maura Duffy lost the basketball. Stevens and Grunewald with the tag team. Here comes Grunewald down the floor. Five-point lead for Clark Willow Lake at 43-38. Stevens has it on the down low. Backs down on Duffy. Lost the ball. Caitlin Duffy's got it back. St. Thomas More on the high low. Racehorse it down. Here's the shot. It's up. Kirch couldn't get it done, but she's fouled. Grunewald picks up the foul. Kirch will go to the line.
Grunewald committing the personal, just her second. I think St. Thomas More has figured out that China Stevens likes to go to her right once with her back to the basket. Last two times they've been right there waiting on her. That time Duffy took it away from her.
Shots up and good for Kirch. The freshman makes it 43-39, 5:25 to go. Grunewald picking up her second foul. If you're keeping score along with us, and if you are, thank you. If you're watching somewhere around the world, thank you again. Second shot is on the way. Kirch couldn't get it done. If you're watching an SDPB2, that's awesome. Thanks so much. It has been an outstanding Class A tournament and one game to go. That's for all the marbles. The Watchdogs of Beersford, the Redmen of Sisseton coming up in the 8 o'clock Central Time neighborhood. 5:09 to go, 43-39. The score, Grunewald tries to bounce out of trouble. Ball goes out of bounds. It will stay in possession of Clark Willow Lake as it's last touched by a Cavalier.
Well, they stopped Grunewald on that baseline, and Stevens kind of dropped into the open area there. St. Thomas More able to get a hand in and deflect the ball out of bounds. Good job by Stevens on the cut. And a good job of the defense. Sometimes it's just a stalemate.
Grunewald to the left side. Delores is there. Won't take the three. Merriam on her top of the defense. Head off to the right side of the circle. Johnson thinks three. Won't take it. Spins around the circle to the left. Grunewald's up there high and dry. Over on the left side for Paulson. Delores in amen quarter to the left. On the top left now for Grunewald. They're chewing up a little bit of time here with 4:43 to go. Here's Johnson's three, front of the rim, no good. And Swedlin coming up with a rebound. That time China Stevens just a bit out of position after the shot, and Swedlin got it. Duffy with the whistle, the foul. It's going to go on Clark Willow Lake's Johnson. That'll be the sixth team foul committed by the Cyclones.
Johnson, the 5'10 senior, Picks up her first. Well, I'm not sure if you're Clark Willow Lake. You're up 43-39 if you want to be settling for three-pointers unless it's Tara DeLaurie who's taking the shot for you.
Duffy the ball. Left-hand dribble around the circle. Get it off the barrier up high. Now on the right side. With the ball is Madison Kirch. Kirch, the freshman, number three on the drive on the left side. Duffy alone for the shot. Partially deflected by Johnson, but Duffy got it back. Here's Caitlin's shot. Too hard. Not going to go. Rebound into the hand of Swedland. Out of bounds. Off a Cyclone. St. Thomas More keeps it.
Duffy kept it alive twice in that one possession. Now her team has another chance to score here.
Katie Friedel coming back into the game. She'll replace Swedland in the St. Thomas More lineup. 4:12 to go in regulation, 43-39. Cavaliers inbound. Friedel into the game with the inbounding on her. And the ball now will come to Kirch. She's around the circle. Marion will have it. Grunwald staring her down on the defense. Top right side of the wheel for Friedel. Left side, Caitlin Duffy. Looks low. Finds somebody there. That's going to be Friedel. There's a foul. That's DeLaurie's.
DeLaurie's on the reach. Friedel doing a good job using her body to shield off to DeLaurie's.
Tri-Valley and Mobridge-Pollock have already been winners in the Saturday session. Tri-Valley winning 7th. Mobridge-Pollock, the 5th place team here at the State A. St. Thomas More's basketball. They trail by 4 at 43-39. Here's Duffy for 2. Good.
That step back jump shot. Gonna have the defense on the heel, step back and fire it up. Doesn't need much room, does she?
And that's such a natural thing for her to do. It looks absolutely effortless for her. Johnson right side, shots up too hard, no good. Caitlin Duffy the rebound. St. Thomas More can tie or take the lead. Duffy has it, working the offense, roll to the right side, fakes right, goes left. Miriam is there, down low for Irity. She's in the big crowd. Go to the right side for Duffy. Johnson picks her up on the defense. On the top for Friedel. Katie spins to the right, goes off to Finch. Or Kirch, excuse me. Finch plays for another team entirely in this tournament. There hasn't been a trade made in this Saturday session. Left side is Miriam. Rolling around the circle to the right. Grunwald with the force. Grunwald with the steal. All by herself. Panic at the disco for the Cyclones. She got it.
Nice job on that defense from Ashley Grunwald. Just like St. Thomas More has figured out that China Stevens likes to go to her right with it when she has her back to the basket. Grunwald set Miriam up perfectly on that play. Miriam's been spinning the same way on that little spin dribble all night. So Grunwald set her up, came behind, picked her pocket cleanly. Nice layup on the other end to give her team back the four-point lead.
Aberdeen Central leading Rapid City Central in the third-place game in AA. 40-33 is that score. That's in the third period. Fourth period score, Highmore Herald by 5 over Centerville. With about 5 minutes left in the fourth in Huron, 41-36.
South Dakota's favorite comedy duo, Williams and Ree, bring their live show to SDPB Television Thursday, March 24th. And you can be a part of the studio audience in Vermilion. A limited number of tickets are on sale online at sdpb.org or by calling during regular business hours. Williams and Ree, live on South Dakota Public TV, Thursday evening, March 24th.
They, of course, the pride of Black Hills State University. Over in Spearfish. That's how they met, formed their comedy act. Did you know Spearfish is one of only two places in the world where the river in town freezes from the bottom up?
No. Where's the other?
I don't know, but in Spearfish it makes it really easy to catch fish.
Okay.
You're just supposed to nod and smile when I come up with those things, all right? I mean, it's absolutely true, but if I knew the other, I would tell you.
And what is the reasoning for this? Is it too involved to go into right now?
My major was not geology, sir. Can't be of much help there. I don't know if I know if anyone who can. Well, there's a guy on our staff, Charles Michael Ray, a geology major at the School of Mines. He would know. But I've got to go find him when we're a little busy. Miriam the ball for St. Thomas More. She's on the dribble drive, puts it up. Didn't get the bucket. There's a foul. She'll go to the line for 2. 45-41 the score. Cavaliers are in the bonus now. That doesn't matter this time around. Grunwald gets the foul. It's her third.
Grunwald coming into the game, into this quarter with no fouls. Now has picked up 3.
First for Miriam is not good.
In 5.5 minutes.
Stevens with 17 to lead the scoring for Clark Willow Lake. 14 for Caitlin Duffy. Miriam has 11. She's had a really sharp game here for St. Thomas More. Second free throw, good. Has 2, gets 1. It's 45-42. 2:39 to play in regulation. Here come the Cyclones, looking to pad the lead or at least keep St. Thomas More from making up any more of the deficit. On the top of the wheel, Grunewald. Keep in mind she has the three fouls. Now she'll look and fire. It's on the way. Off the side of the rim. Wouldn't go for her. Bree Arity there for the rebound. St. Thomas More takes it back. Cavaliers bring it down to the offense. Duffy left side, Miriam looking to get their 13th point of the night. Shots on the way. Skips out. Won't go. Rebound Stevens. China Stevens by herself gets the authority rebound. Here comes Clark Willow Lake bringing it down. Off the left side of the wheel. This is Paulson. Bounce pass on the top for Johnson. Minute 55. Got to make the Cavaliers come after them in just a bit here. Grunewald between the rings. Over to Delores. On the top again for Grunewald. Spins around the circle. Double teamed. Over on the right side, Tara Delores. Not in position to take the three-point shot. She will break a tournament record if she makes one here in the final minute, 38. Paulson double teamed against the trap. Whistle. Timeout is called. Good timeout that time by Wade Stubbs of Clark Willow Lake, John.
Well, nothing else to do. They had Paulson stop there and was going to either take the ball away from her or foul her. And I'm not sure about it as far as the free throw percentages go, but I do know that Paulson has not played a whole lot in this tournament and kind of a tough situation to put her in the shooting free throws for the win or to extend your lead.
Minute and 36 to go in the fourth period, 45-41, Clark Willow Lake leading St. Thomas More. There have been a total of 15 points in the period, 8 of those by Clark Willow Lake.
Well, if you're St. Thomas More looking for someone to foul, Ashley Tonak with 45% free throw shooting, and Tonak is on the floor now, and Paulson is off the floor. So, and Paulson shooting about 50% on the season from the free throw line. Everybody else for Clark Willow Lake, above 60%.
Ashley Tonak is coming back in for Clark Willow Lake. She has four fouls, minute and 30 to go. Johnson just about travels, some trouble with the pivot foot, but she got it done. Here's Grunewald in some timber, looking toward the right side. Delores won't take the 25-footer. Getting it off on the top of the circle between the rings was Grunewald and a foul, and that will go in Katie Friedel.
And that's five for Friedel. She's gone. Second night in a row that Friedel has fouled out.
And that is going to end her basketball career at St. Thomas More High School. Katie Friedel leaves the game with five fouls, four rebounds, and 4 points.
Well, you get down to this point in the tournament, you know you're playing your last game for these seniors. It's a huge emotional night for your senior players.
Bill Friedel, the assistant coach, not very happy with the call. He's discussing it with Willie Circle Eagle. Brandon Candelon gets a full 60 seconds to bring somebody in after the fifth foul. And that somebody's going to be Maura Duffy. Minute 20 to go, 45-42. St. Thomas More trailing. Ashley Grunewald at the free throw line. Grunewald on the night. 4 rebounds, 5 points. Her team up 3. Minute 20 to go. First up, all she's going to get is it missed. Went high off the back of the rim and into the hands of Maura Duffy. Tripping with the basketball was Caitlin Duffy. No traveling violation called. Is right there with the save was Kirch. Maura Duffy on top. On the right for Swedland. She's out on the high right. Tonak is on her. Minute 3 to go. St. Thomas More's got to get a move on. Duffy on the top for Miriam. Heads toward amen quarter to the left side. Duffy's got it again. Timeout called. St. Thomas More.
Well, Cavs trail by 3. And Caitlin Duffy. Clark Willow Lake knows that you're down by 3. They know you're looking for the 3 if you can get it. They know Duffy's your best 3-point shooter. So, yeah, they're going to stay right with Caitlin Duffy. Now, if they pay too much attention to Duffy, watch for Miriam to spring free on the backside. A little skip pass, and there's an open 3 for Miriam.
And, of course, with both Duffys, Maura Duffy can make some noise as well. They've got a somewhat smallish lineup there. Well, Arity is staying in the game. Miriam and Kirsch playing the guards now, and Kirsch is going to have to go the rest of the way with Friedel out of the game.
Coffee stain.
Oh. I had somebody.
That's a whole new meaning. To
I had somebody from one of the cheering sections ask me if I was going to spill my coffee again tonight. Came right down and asked me while I was getting ready for the broadcast, and I said, well, they weren't going to let me in the building if I didn't have a cup with a lid. So I do. May I state categorically for the record, that was not my fault. And it's nobody's fault. I mean, it's just part of the game of basketball, but a lot of coffee.
What happens when you bring coffee to a basketball game?
Boy, the coffee goes fast around here sometimes, doesn't it? 37 seconds and counting. Duffy with the shot. Couldn't get it done. Duffy tries to get her own rebound. She's fouled.
Stevens going to pick up the foul. What a move by Caitlin Duffy. Everybody expecting the three. What does Duffy do? Drive right to the basket. Take the quick two, cut it, and trying to cut it to one, and that would open up a whole new world of possibilities.
And 34-5 is plenty of time to get something going on the offense. But you got to hit the free throw there, and they didn't, and Tonak got the rebound.
Rare miss for Duffy.
Clark Willow Lakes basketball. St. Thomas More 27 seconds away from just their second loss of the year. Right side, here's Johnson on the drive. She is brought down to the floor by Caitlin Duffy. And Johnson's going to go to the line. Tess will shoot two.
Fourth foul on Duffy. Beersford and Sissonon coming up next. The State A Girls Basketball Championship. Sissonon appearing in their second straight State A Girls Championship game.
First is good for Johnson. There were a lot of people saying Clark Willow Lake could have been a finalist in this tournament, but you look up and down the line, there are any one of maybe five, maybe six teams that could have gone fairly deep in this thing in Class A. Second shot up, good, 47-42. Long way to go and a short time to get there for the Cavaliers now. Merriam will bring it down. Grunwald on her on the defense. Off on the right side of the wheel. That's Kirch. As to the left side, knocked away by Johnson. Duffy on the save. 11 seconds, 10 seconds. Caitlin Duffy driving on Stevens. She'll stop at back pedal. Go to the top of the wheel now. That is going to be Kirch. 4 seconds. Brandon Candlin calling timeout. Awful lot of time wasted setting up on the offense, John.
Well, and that's what happens with this young team. And I asked Coach Candlin about that before the game. You know, about the coming down to the end of the game last night, if maybe he thought some of their youth and inexperience might have showed, and he agreed that more than likely it did. And I think that's what you're seeing right here, Gary, is just a case of the youth coming out. I mean, you're looking out there, you got freshmen, sophomores, and eighth graders all over the place.
And no senior leadership and because your lone seniors fouled out.
Exactly. So I really think that's most of what's going on right now. It took them a long time to get into their offense, get into the try to get a shot off. I think you're seeing their youth. This tournament right this year is going to give them a lot of experience coming back next season. I think they're a force to be reckoned with here in the coming years.
Absolutely. And you look at the experience that the backup point guard is getting. Madison Kirsch has gotten a lot of minutes in this state tournament, and that's only going to help down the line. She'll have 3 years left in the Cavalier uniform. 4-4 left, and a quick timeout called once again. Either Brandon Candlin saw something that he wasn't thrilled with, or he's going to set up a whole new situation here. 47-42 the score. Get some other tournament scores from AA and B in just a bit. And a lot of these should be really close to finals. Aberdeen Central by 2 over Rapid City Central in the fourth with 3:07. That's 48-46. Centerville has taken the lead late on Highmore Herald. The Tornadoes 44-43. That's with 12 seconds left to go in the fourth in the B tournament third place game.
Wow, Highmore Herald, last score handle there was up by 4 or 5 in that ball game. Looked like they're going to put it away.
The tournament championships tonight, AA, Sioux Falls O'Gorman against Brandon Valley. The A tournament here in Watertown featuring Sissonon and Beersford. And in Class B, Summit and Newell. Duffy the long three, 2 seconds to go, 1 second. This one's over. Clark Willow Lake is your third place team in the state Class A tournament. The Cyclones bouncing back from a tough loss to Beersford, defeating St. Thomas More 47-42 tonight. That puts St. Thomas More, the fourth place team. They finish with a 24-2 record on the season. Clark Willow Lake advancing to the third place, the bronze trophy. It's not the bronze trophy, certainly, but the bronze position going to the Clark Willow Lake squad as they get the decision 47-42. Just a matter of tempo and just a matter of shaking off any deficits that they had during the game. They played their game. They chipped away at the lead. They didn't try to make up everything all at once, and a lot of people contributed for the Cyclones tonight, John.
Well, and it started with Tara DeLores, who tied the state record for most made threes in the tournament with 14. DeLores, those back-to-back threes in the third quarter really turned things around. Clark Willow Lake outscoring St. Thomas More 16-9 in that third quarter to pull out the win. Major funding for broadcast of high school championships on SDPB is provided by Dakota Bank. In Dakota Territory, we honor the past and prepare for the future. All across South Dakota, Dakota Bank is here for you. And by Mid-Continent Communication. Mid-Continent Communications Northern Plains Network is how more businesses stay connected throughout the region. Midcocom.com/NPNet. final numbers for the game. I thought I had the final numbers here for this third place game. Let me see if I can pull this up here on the old computer. Good thing I'm not tallying up. There they are. Final numbers. Here we go. Clark first for St. Thomas More, claiming fourth place at the 2011 state tournament. They were led tonight in scoring by Caitlin Duffy with 14 points. Duffy finished the night 5 of 23 from the field, 3 of 4 at the line with 9 rebounds. 12 points for Maddie Miriam. Miriam 3 of 5 behind the 3-point line. And 3 points for Madison Kirsch. 4 points for Katie Friedel before fouling out. And 8 points for Bree Arity. Arity 3 of 4 from the field. For Clark Willow Lake, they were led tonight by China Stevens, outstanding sophomore. Stevens finishing 5 of 8 from the field, 17 points, 13 rebounds, 7 of 9 at the free throw line for Stevens. 12 points for Tara DeLorries. DeLorries finished out 3 of 6 from behind the 3-point line. And again, to tie the state record of Kristen Roeder, who knocked down 14 threes over the tournament. And I'm not sure about the years, a few years ago, though, but nice job by Tara DeLorries tying that record. 8 points for Tess Johnson, 3 points for Ashley Tonak for Clark Willow Lake. Always picks the wrong time to update here. And also 2 points for Mackenzie Huber off the bench, 5 points for Ashley Gruenwald. Clark Willow Lake again taking third place in the team stats. Here we go. St. Thomas More wound up the game shooting 30% from the field, 15 of 49, 66% at the free throw line, 8 of 12 at the charity stripe, 26 rebounds. They had 9 turnovers on the night. Clark Willow Lake 36% for the game, 14 of 38 from the field, 4 of 16 on threes, 15 of 20 at the free throw line for 75%, 32 rebounds, 6 assists, 5 steals, and 11 turnovers on the night for Clark Willow Lake.
Our final once again, 47-42, so 6 spots decided in the state girls A tournament. The 8th place team, Madison. 7th is Tri-Valley. Winner is the 8th place team. 7th place, then, is Tri-Valley. 6th place going this afternoon to Madison. Mulbridge Pollock finishing in 5th place. 4th place now, St. Thomas More. And your new third place team in the Class A State Girls Tournament is Clark Willow Lake, the Cyclones, with a 47-42 decision over St. Thomas More. Some of the late scorers in the tournament in the Class AA field and the Class B. Highmore Herald has defeated Centerville. That was a 45-44 final. Highmore Herald evidently getting some late points in that one to take the third place trophy. The Pirates over the Tornadoes, 45-44. And we'll get an update on the AA game in just a bit here. That was Rapid City Central taking on Aberdeen Central. And that's 49-48, Rapid City Central. They actually tied that now at 49-49 with a couple of minutes to go in period number 4 in regulation time over in Brookings. The Class AA Championship will feature Sioux Falls O'Gorman, the Knights taking on the Lynx of Brandon Valley. In Class A, in just a matter of minutes, it's action between the Beersford Watchdogs and the Sisseton Redmen, Southeast South Dakota and Northeast South Dakota duking it out for the state Class A title. And in Class B tonight, the Eagles of Summit representing Northeast South Dakota taking on the Newell Irrigators, the Irrigators of the Black Hills Conference, and out west in Meade County. Our final once again, 47-42, as Clark Willow Lake is the third place winner, defeating St. Thomas More by that 5-point tally here in Watertown at the Civic Arena. We'll take a few minutes, stretch your legs, take a break. We'll all take a deep breath and get ready for what should be a very entertaining Class A championship game. The Beersford Watchdogs coming out of the number 3 seed against the number 4 seed, Sisseton Redmen. The Redmen, the home squad on the scoreboard. You see them warming up in the white uniforms. Beersford will be in the road purple. Let that soak into your cerebral hemispheres, and we will rejoin you in just a few minutes here from the Watertown Civic Arena. The championship game coming up of the State Class A Girls Basketball Tournament. We will rejoin you in just a few minutes on SDPB.org and on SDPB Television 2. You've been watching a copyrighted broadcast brought to you under rights granted by the South Dakota High School Activities Association.